friends, welcome to my channel Eternal Love for Baking and Food. Today I'll be sharing a very nice recipe made with dried cranberries. Cranberries are powerhouse of antioxidants and they boost up your brain power also, so it's very good for kids as well. My recipe is dried cranberries scones. Do try this and share it among your friends and enjoy with tea or coffee. The basic ingredients for our dried cranberry and lemon zest scones are all-purpose flour. This is around 260 grams, 2.5 cups of all-purpose flour. This is caster sugar, which are coarsely powdered, neither granulated nor powdered, but coarsely powdered. Then I have one egg. Vegetarians can skip on egg and they can replace it with fresh cream. 2.5 teaspoon of baking powder. Then I'll be taking 1 teaspoon around lemon zest, then around 80 grams of dried cranberries. You can replace it with fresh cranberries if it's available, or any fruit of your choice like raisins or apricots. Then 1 cup of butter. It has to be frozen and cool butter, not melted. I have taken cubes of butter. Add 1 teaspoon of vanilla essence also, and around 1/4 cup of milk, 1/2 cup of whipping cream. For glazing, I'll be using icing sugar and lemon juice. That will be at the end once our scones are baked. We'll start with sifting our all-purpose flour. Now we'll add the lemon zest for flavor. You can replace it with orange zest also if you want to make orange zest scones. Now we'll just mix it with hands slightly. Now add your butter. Start gradually mixing it with your flour. Crush it like this with your hands. We'll do it like this, because this gives that flaky touch inside your scones. See, the mixture looks rough and crumbly, but still the butter is visible. This is what we want, like this. Okay? Now we'll prepare our wet ingredients by mixing milk, whipping cream, egg and vanilla extract. This is mixed. One important thing that I need to mention is I have not mixed the entire milk. I have kept little bit, because if we mix it and if we pour the entire thing here, we may lose the consistency. If required, we'll add more at a later stage. I'm not adding more. I'm leaving it because we have already got it in the form of a dough. It has come together, so no need to add any more liquid into it. Now I'll take it to my work surface and I'll roll it into a dough. I'll sprinkle some flour now to give it a form of a dough. Adding in my cranberries. I'm using dried cranberries. You can use fresh cranberries also, or raisins or apricots. Now I'll mix this and knead my dough again. My daughter is also here to help me kneading the dough for our cranberry scones. We'll pat the dough like this, and it will be around 1.5 inch thick, like this. Now we'll cut it into wedges and then I have put a parchment paper on my baking dish. Then I'll place it here and I'll bake it at 200 degrees centigrade for around 20 minutes. Other shape also, if you want you can use your cookie cutters and give different shapes. I'm putting it the traditional way in the triangle shape. We'll leave some gap while placing it because they are going to puff up, so you need to leave some space when you are placing the wedges. We have baked it for around 20 minutes and our scones are done. This is how it looks. Now we glaze it with lemon juice and sugar. Now we'll prepare our glaze for our 1 tablespoon of lemon juice. I'll take icing sugar in this. Now this is how it looks. See, it has got the drizzling consistency. Now we'll glaze our scones. This is done. This is how it looks. Now I'll let it settle for around 1 hour and then I'll serve.